Good morning, family. If you'd stand with us, happy Father's Day to you, dads. Good to be with you. I'm glad that you've chosen to take your family to church this morning, whether that is in here, outside, at home. I think it's so important for us as dads to let our kids know that Christ comes first. And I just want to make sure that we understand that. Yeah, there's lots of fun things that we can do, but the best thing we can do as dads is to show our kids that they need to seek the Lord. We do that first, then everything else comes after that. But it's going to be a good day today. Pastor Jim is speaking this morning. We get to hear a word of the Lord from him. I'm excited for it. But before we have an opportunity to worship the Lord, if you would just bow your heads with me, let's prepare our hearts before the Lord. Heavenly Father, I thank you, God, that you're here in this place. I thank you, Lord, that you are our Heavenly Father. I know for some, being a father or remembering their father is difficult. Maybe they've had bad experiences. Help us, Lord, to see you only in those situations, to see you as the example. You are loving, you are caring, you are gracious, you are merciful, and you care for us. And we thank you for an opportunity right now today to celebrate you, to lift up your name. And I pray, Lord, with one voice that we would rejoice in you this morning, we pray. And it's in Jesus' mighty name. Everyone said, amen. All right, we're going to worship together. We've practiced up here. Now it's your turn to be a part of us, to get a chance to sing, to rejoice, to lift his name. Let's do that this morning. His love awakens me.
Yeah.
Amen, amen. Our love awakens us this morning. Hope you are awake. If not, get ready. Come on up, Wesley. Let's hear a word of the Lord this morning. He's got the big Bible. I like it.
Good morning, church family. Today I'm going to read Matthew 11:27. All things have been committed to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and those whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Let's continue to worship the Lord.
All right. Amen. Let's do that.
Great day. We give you freedom, awaken the light.
Hallelujah. Oh, hero from heaven. You conquered the grave. God, I'm so thankful every day I can go to you. Knowing that I don't have to worry about all that I'm doing, I can trust in the God who's done great things. I can trust in the God who opens the doors. You find a way, you make a way. Thank you. On you as a celestial Santa Claus, wanting something immediately, and gimme, gimme, gimme. This whole environment, the last 50 years, has accelerated our expectation of your answered prayer, and we forget of the moments like Moses waiting upon you for 7 days to hear your voice. God, take us back to a faith that's rich in the heritage of our ancestors. But we would stop looking for the results, and we would trust in the process, knowing that is who you are. You will make a way. You're our only hope. Hallelujah.
Has spoken my
buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declared the grave has no claim on me. Then came the morning that sealed the promise. Your buried body began to breathe. Out of the silence, the roaring lion declares the grave has no claim on me. Oh, oh, Jesus, yours is the this morning, us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the one who set us free. He is the way maker, the miracle worker, the life giver, our sure foundation. He is our salvation. He is hope. He is our Savior, our Redeemer, our mighty God. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. You are worthy, Lord. Good day to praise the Lord. I just want to encourage you. At times it's easy to fall prey to the emotion or the feelings, and maybe we're like, I'm just not feeling it today. Just step in. Allow yourself to say, I'm going to praise the Lord today. I'm going to lift up his name, because I promise you, there's something inherent in your soul. Your soul knows, it understands who God is. And in those moments when we say, I'm not feeling it today, but I'm going to make that decision. God hears that. He sees that. He knows that's a sacrifice for you. And that freedom, that that ability to rejoice in Christ comes when you just say, oh, all right, I give up. I'm not worried about my pride. I'm not worried about what others think of me. I'm going to declare you righteous, Lord. I'm going to declare you holy. I'm going to praise your name. I'm going to lift my voice and sing. God doesn't want someone embarrassed of him. I'm encouraged this morning as we just continue to celebrate his goodness. That's a good thing. There's so many psalms that just say, shout to the Lord, declare his goodness. Let's get into that routine. And generally, oftentimes, those phrases are right after, God, what are you doing? I don't see you working at all. But I will rejoice. I will praise you. Heavenly Father, I pray right now, as we just continue in this service, that we would know you are here. That you never stop working in our lives, and we can have a peace that surpasses all understanding because we know you make a way. If that door's not open, it's not worth going in it. Because you haven't opened it for us, we'll go somewhere else. Father, help us to trust in you, to seek you. May you be glorified, God, in this time. And it's in Jesus' mighty name, everyone said. Amen. Amen. If you could just give the Lord a little more praise, and you can have your seat. You're worthy, Father. Thank you.